Dear all, we are going to discuss the most important, most useful, application-oriented AM demodulator, which lies under the category of non-coherent demodulator and is known as linear diode demodulator or envelope detector. It is very simple, less expensive, with satisfactory performance for its reception of broadcast communication. And we still utilizing this demodulator in radio broadcasting communication. In this, the diode is utilized and which is operated in the linear region of its characteristics. And with this linear region operating point, we recover the envelope from AM modulated signal. And this envelope is corresponding to the recovery of our baseband signal or modulating signal or message signal, which we want to get at the output of our receiver. So, for operating in linear region, the input signal is equivalent to 1 volt or more than 1 volt, so that it can be operated in the linear region. Now, the diagram of this linear diode detector is shown in the figure. So, as per the diagram, we have received input AM modulated signal. After that, we have resistance RS. Then this signal is passed from diode. And after that, we have capacitor and load resistance, that is RL. So, as per the diagram, if we assume that the capacitor is absent, then this diagram is behave like a half wave rectifier, and the total resistance is equivalent to RS plus RD plus RL, and the RD is the diode resistance when the diode operated in the forward bias according to the input AM modulated received signal. Now we consider this diagram and introduce the capacitor in the circuit. Then it have two part. Part A is corresponding to input when it is operated with positive half cycle. In that, the diode gets forward bias and behave as short circuit. And the time constant, which is RS into C, should be small so that the capacitor rapidly charges corresponding to input signal. So, the value of RS into C should be small. This is very important because as the time pass, the capacitor gets charged by source voltage, but its value is slightly less than the source voltage due to some loss as per the presence of resistance. Now we take the second part, in which we consider the negative half cycle of the input signal. In this, the diode get reverse bias and behave as open circuit. And in this situation, the capacitor which is charged in positive half cycle get discharged across the load resistance RL. This will give an important point. You must be careful about this situation. I repeat, the capacitor start discharging through the load resistance RL and it contains the time constant tau, which is equivalent to RL into C. Spikes are introduced due to charging and discharging of the capacitor. So, as per the recovery of envelope of AM wave, there is requirement that the capacitor should be discharged slowly, and the capacitor discharges slowly if the time constant, that is tau, is equal to RL into C, should be contains large value, and this will give the small spikes at the demodulated output. Now we found that the time constant is properly chosen. If we consider their proper value, then the voltage across the capacitor does not fall appreciably during the small period of negative half cycle. And by that time, the next positive cycle appears and this process continues. And the voltage across the capacitor, just like a spiky baseband signal. And the voltage across the capacitor result the envelope of modulated carrier, which is our detected baseband signal. As per the conclusion summary, there is requirement of small value of Rs into C so that the capacitor charges rapidly, and further there is requirement of another time constant, that is tau, which is equivalent to RL into C, should be large so that the capacitor discharging slowly. As per both the point, we get our desired signal, which is according to the detection of envelope of input received AM modulated signal. Now the time constant tau, which is equivalent to RL into C, should be large, and their more large value result in the diagonal clipping, in which the negative peaks of the detected envelope may be completely or partially missing, and which we will discuss in the next lecture. Now we have the characteristics of envelope detector as shown in the diagram. In this, the input AM modulated signal is applied, and that is a corresponding to linear region. We get the characteristics this. And in this characteristics, it is clearly shown the diode is on, capacitor gets charging. And if the diode is off, the capacitor starts discharging. And as per the charging and discharging behavior of the capacitor, we resulted the voltage across the capacitor, and which gives the envelope of the modulated carrier wave, which is desired modulating signal. So according to the behavior of the envelope detector, the two types of distortion are occur in the detected output, and the one is corresponding to diagonal clipping and another is corresponding to negative peak clipping. Both these clipping we will discuss in our next lecture. And the diagonal clipping is very, very important for your exam point of view as well as for your competitive. And with this, we complete the behavior of linear diode detector, and which is also known as envelope detector.
Thank you very much for your precious time, and please subscribe this channel for getting regular updates.